Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. On July 10th, our Juno spacecraft completed its seventh perijove, or close flyby, of Jupiter. It flew directly over the planet's iconic Great Red Spot, about 5,600 miles above it. All of the spacecraft's science instruments and its JunoCam imager were active, providing the first up-close look at the 10,000-mile-wide storm that has intrigued humans for hundreds of years. Juno's next close flyby of Jupiter will occur on September 1st. A new flyover video was released to celebrate the two-year anniversary of our New Horizons spacecraft's flyby of Pluto, which happened July 14, 2015. Meanwhile, on July 10th, our Sophia aircraft used its 100-inch telescope to probe the space around 2014 MU69 as the small Kuiper Belt object occulted or passed in front of a star. The event provided an opportunity to look for debris that might pose a risk when New Horizons flies by on January 1st, 2019. During the week of July 10th, we teamed with military personnel in the waters off the coast of Galveston, Texas, to evaluate various techniques astronauts will use to safely exit our Orion spacecraft after it returns from deep space missions and splashes down in the Pacific Ocean. Ideally, small boats of Navy personnel will be able to quickly assist the crew, returning it and Orion to an awaiting naval ship. Orion is designed to sustain a crew that is splashed down in the ocean for up to 24 hours. Our Langley Research Center hosted a Centennial Symposium July 12th through 14th at the Hampton Roads, Virginia Convention Center. The event marked the 100th anniversary of the center and featured NASA aerospace experts, those from industry, government, other space agencies, as well as officials from academia. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at www.nasa.gov.